Daytona. Seen come up and fuck up the owner. Seen throw up Westside, California. Nigga, I'm hot as Phoenix, Arizona. I'm Utah. I got multiple bitches. It's a new law. Keep a hold of your riches. Dumb nigga, don't spend it. As soon as you get it and recognize I'm a captain, you a lieutenant. I can say what I wanna say, ain't nothing to it. Gangsta rap made me do it. Made me do it. If I call you a nigga, ain't nothing to it. Gangsta rap made me do it. I can act like an animal, ain't nothing to it. Gangsta rap made me do it.
Welcome to Maniacal Music Musings. We are glad to have you back for another special artist bracket. And I just want to say, the two of us here, we are America's most wanted by far, and we are natural born killers. I'm your host, Jeremy. And on this Friday, we're steady mobbing to tell you why we thugs. My life's been wicked, and sure as fuck ain't no gangsta's fairy tale. It's all good, though. You know, I smoke some weed. Well, I tell you, get off my dick and tell your bitch to come here. My co-host, though, oof, he a hood-robbing motherfucker who wants to grip the nappy dugout every day. He feeds his ghetto birds during his summer vacation and says it was a good day. So say hello to him before he drops the bomb up your ass with no Vaseline. Chancy, what? Motherfucking Grife.
No Vaseline? Hi.
Oh, you damn straight, no Vaseline.
Vaseline.
And if you couldn't tell by now, people watching, listening, we are here for a very special bracket that was picked by me because he is one of my favorite rap artists of all time. Yeah, I know, Munchie, right? He's the greatest. You love him. You always fucking bob your head to him. And we are, of course, talking about the NWA original fucking Ice Cube.
I like to call him Frozen Ice.
I can respect that. And yeah, it makes sense. I mean, it's better than like our Fresh Prince with the fucking name Ice Tray, but yeah.
Yeah, frozen water, aka Ice Cube.
Aggressively chilled water.
But for this bracket tonight, we are joined by three special guests to make it a fun bracket. Of course, I have Mr. No Vaseline number one, my good homie from Masturbators and Season to Season podcasts, CJ Tucker.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
Oh, yeah, my pleasure. Our pleasure, I should say. Our pleasure. And of course, I had to get Miss CL back from CL Pussy Talks.
Ew, what's up, y'all? What's up? Thanks for having me.
And last, but certainly not fucking least by any means, my co-host, beautiful better half, Casey Walla.
Hello.
And yes, we are here to... Yeah, she's good looking, I know. Enough, guys. Jesus. But we are here tonight to do a 36-song Ice Cube bracket to break down Ice Cube's 36 best songs. Motherfuckers. Hold a moment, though, before my laptop fucking dies because of fucking them not quite
right. Love going live.
I hate dogs. I really hate dogs.
You take that back.
I love dogs. I just don't want to own them, okay? There's a difference. Because literally, they could just kill my laptop if I didn't act fast enough for that shit and my microphone. Y'all motherfuckers are gonna not get food tomorrow, I swear to God.
Everything's gone.
I'm gonna eat damn food.
You get meat on your ass.
But yes, we are here to represent one of the original godfathers of gangsta rap himself. The man, the myth, the legend. Don't call him Doughboy, but you know he's gonna fuck you up, boy. Ice Cube.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't he more like Crushed Ice now since he's doing family movies?
he does them with that gangsta angle, though. So you know he's still good. But
yeah. And of course, he played the two movies where kids beat him up.
I love his movies, so I'm not complaining. But Right. He's a funny actor. He really is. I mean, Barbershop is amazing because of him mainly. But I will. The order on this episode is going to be Casey's going to start us off, followed by CL, followed by Chancelot, followed by CJ, and then myself bringing up the rear. Sorry, CJ. But either way, we're going to start this off right with Casey. You're going first, of course. It's number 14, Gangsta Rap Made Me Do It, versus number 29, Really Dope.
Gangsta Rap Made Me Do It.
I respect that option. And CL, which way you want to go?
I'm going to go with Gangsta Rap Made Me Do It because I don't know neither one of the songs, but that title is cooler than the other one.
There are playlists for a reason, people. But
well, I got, but you know, I can't remember all the names of the playlists.
Wasn't I just asked today to be on it?
Yeah, yeah, you were.
I didn't get home from work until like 1:30, and then I had stuff to do.
Right. How's it going, Brian? I can't listen to Ice Cube at work, bitch. So.
I can headphones, but what up, my fellow bastard? But, and that means that it's going to go down to Chancy. Chancy, is Gangsta Rap Made Me Do It moving on, or are you giving one to Really Though?
Yeah.
Which means Gangsta Rap Made Me Do It will be moving on. But which way would you have gone, CJ?
Oh, Gangsta Rap Made Me Do It. Oh, definitely.
Well, you know what that means, folks. We have our first, what is that called, Chancy, of the night?
A sweep.
This cat is going.
It's a sweet.
Sweet.
It didn't sound like Chancy, but I'll take it. And the best part about doing brackets on Google Sheets now is I can't see the screen while I'm doing it. That's the fun part. I got to get that fucking double monitor hookup going on soon. But, oh, we having a good Friday night talking about the master of Fridays, Mr. Ice Cube himself, Brian. So, you know. And that's actually funny because CL starts this next matchup up. To see who get what Gangsta Rap Made Me Do It will face. And it's number 13, Friday. Number 13, Friday. I just realized that. That's funny. Versus number 28, You Can't Fade Me.
Friday is throw your motherfucking hands in the air. Oh, bump, bump. If you don't.
Yeah, if you don't.
I'm going to go Friday. I'm going Friday.
All right. That's one vote for Friday. But what about you, Chancy? Which way are you going to go?
Oh, dude, fucking Friday.
And CJ?
Friday all day.
Which means Friday will move on into the second round to face Gangsta Rap Made Me Do It. But personally on this one, I don't know. I guess I have to go Friday because You Can't Fade Me was not like the best song ever in my opinion. So I wasn't that big a fan of Friday either, but I guess I got to go with it for this matchup. But, Casey, which way would you have gone?
Same.
Sweet? Sweet?
Yeah.
Sweet?
Right,
so far. So far. It's going to get harder, trust me.
Yeah.
But this one gets started off by Chancelot. And it's number 12, Ghetto Bird, versus number 27, Wicked.
Ouch.
Ooh.
I'm gonna go Wicked.
And CJ?
All right, yeah. Now this is the first tough one. Right. I love Ghetto Bird, but I gotta go with Wicked on this one.
Yeah. And I am so happy you said that because Wicked's moving on to the next round because I'm gonna vote for Wicked too because I fucking love that song. This is actually the first time I heard that song and I'm amazed because. It kind of sounds like the beginning of hardcore rap almost in a way. I mean, maybe not the beginning, but like a good starter track. Not exactly the beginning, though. That happened about 6 or 8 years before, so. But which way would you have gone, Casey?
Yep.
And CEO,
which way would you? Edelberg, because we can't sweep everything.
Respect. Well, that means Wicked will move on 4-1 to the next round. But to see what it will face, we have another bird theme song in this matchup. And this one's going to get started out by CJ. It's number 11, The Ninja Trap, versus number 26, A Bird in the Hand.
Yeah, I'm going Ninja Trap.
All right. Oh, for me in this one, I actually have to see if either of these I actually like hard it on Spotify before I even, because I know them, I remember them, but I just can't freaking think which one I like better at this time.
I listened to the playlist all day yesterday while I was drinking.
Oh, wait a minute. Yeah. Wait a minute. Where the hell is the other one? I can't even find the other one. Oh, yeah, there it is. Okay. Nope. The Ninja Rap got put in my liked list on Spotify, so definitely The Ninja Trap. But which way you want to go there, Casey?
Huh? Sorry.
You want to go The Ninja Trap or Bird in the Hand?
Ninja Trap. I was checking out my drink. Sorry.
Which means
she saw cane sugar and showed it to me. I was like, it's not that kind of cane, darling.
But that. I mean, she did you, Chancy, so all
better. Some uptown.
But that means the Ninja Trap will move on to face Wicked in the second round. But, and just for all our listeners out there who are like, what the hell are you talking about, Ninja Trap? We're using ninja to replace another word that shouldn't be said on podcast, so.
Shouldn't be said at all.
Just go with it. But
facts.
And they probably would have gathered that anyway. So
yeah, you know, I mean, you know.
I don't like to assume people's intelligence levels. But which way would you have gone there, CL?
What was the choices? Ninja Trap or what else?
Two Bird in the Hand.
A Bird in the Hand.
Let's go with Ninja Trap.
And last but not least, Chancy, which way would you have gone?
I'm going to go with Bird in the Hand because it's always worth two in the bush, and fucking two's always better than one if you ask me.
Well, I mean, if you ask Ice Cube, a bird in the bush is better than a bird in the hand.
Well, since we can't ask him, what's the answer to
the I mean, we could ask him if someone can get him to come on the show. I would love that. He's alive still. Mm-hmm. He's alive and kicking. But that means
I'm in danger.
which means I get to start off the next matchup, and this one's gonna be I feel like should be difficult. For me it isn't, but this one is number 10, Once Upon a Time in the Projects, versus 25, A Gangsta's Fairy Tale.
Ooh.
And honestly, before I've heard Gangster's Fairy Tale before, but I really listened to it this time a couple times, and I was just like, Once Upon a Time, the Projects is a good song, but it's just, I used to like it a lot more, but it's just kind of boring, actually, in a way, so I'm going for Gangster's Fairy Tale. But which way you want to go there, Casey?
Yeah, I'll do the same, Gangster's Fairy Tale. This cat is gonna freaking get away.
I swear to God, Gangsta's Fairy Tale almost like reminds me of something ICP would do, but or Green Jelly. But which way do you want to go, CL?
Gangsta's Fairy Tale. It sounds.
Oh, there ain't no freaking way that just happened. Whoa, that cat just ripped ass on me. Like, this kitten is like 3.5 months old, and it's like, it's bad. Like, it, she can clear out a room.
That's why you don't feed your cat Taco Bell.
I'm not sure who this guy is, but Virgil wants to say hi from Manchester, England.
Hey, Virgil.
And
good morning to you.
People have a go at Nile crocodiles, but keep the Egyptian population down. Okay, I don't know what that means.
Wait,
okay.
What?
Exactly. I don't know what that means, not Virgil, but okay. Well, I'll rock with it. I'll rock with it.
It's not like somebody humping handbags. I don't know.
And yeah, hey, buddy. But that, That brings this one down to Sir Chancelot. Is it Gangsta's Fairy Tale or Once Upon a Time in the Projects?
Yep, Gangsta's Fairy Tale.
And last but not least, CJ, which way would you have gone?
Once Upon a Time in the Projects.
Okay, I'm happy you got one. I'm honestly happy you got one vote because I didn't want to see a sweep on that one. I just didn't.
Yeah, there's just too many sweeps in this right now.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's two to two in the sweeps right now, so it's even. But this one gets started out by Casey. We're back at the top. And it's number 9, My Summer Vacation, versus number 24, Steady Mobbin.
What was it, Steady Vacation?
My summer vacation versus Steady Mobbin.
Oh. I don't know. I'll go with the vacation one.
I'm going to go with Steady Mobbin if it's my turn.
It is your turn, so perfect. Chancy, how about you?
Yep.
And CJ, are you going to tie it up Steady for Mobbin. Me? Or are you going to... you ain't going to tie it up. And I would have voted for my Steady Mobbin anyway, because Steady Mobbin is one of those classic Ice Cube songs that you know is right. Ice Cube. But... to bring us to the last two matchups of this half of round one, we have number 8, The Ninja You Love to Hate, versus number 23, Endangered Species. And this one gets started off by CL.
The Ninja That You Love to Hate.
And Chanty?
Yeah.
And CJ, are you pushing the Ninja You Love to Hate onto the
Of course.
Right?
Yeah.
And I would have done that anyway because it's the Ninja You Love to Hate is another classic Ice Cube hit. I think all of his top eight pretty much are, but we'll see what everybody else feels like. But which way would you have gone, Casey?
Yep.
Which means we have our third sweep of the night here. But to see what they're going to be facing, there are two play-ins we could do for this half for round one. And the first play-in is going to get started off by Chancy. And it's number 30, Smoke Some Weed, versus number 34, featuring George Clinton, Pop Gun, One Nation.
He's about to be a smart ass.
I just did what you told me to do, man.
He chose another first one, if you didn't get that.
I was watching the camera, so I didn't.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to go with Smoke Weed.
I kind of figured. But CJ, how about you? Pop Gun or Smoke Some Weed?
Pop Gun.
Yeah, Pop Gun's good. I just wanted to be a smart ass.
And personally, I am going to go with Smoke Some Weed because, like, I smoke weed to and from work and on my lunch at work, and like that song was special to me the last couple days during my lunch breaks when it would come on. But which way are you going to go, Casey? Are you going to tie it up for CL, or are you going to go put Smoke Some Weed through?
Not the smoking weed one, the other one.
Oh, Pop Gun.
There you go.
Which means, CL, you get the first tiebreaker of this whole back bracket so far.
Okay.
Smoke Some Weed versus Pop Gun, One Nation, featuring George Clinton.
I'm going to go with George Clinton because I love him.
Yeah.
There you go.
Under the groove and keep it
going. And yeah. I can't be mad at that. But to see what Pop Gun's gonna face in the next round, and then in round one, we have a second play-in matchup, and this one gets started by CJ, and it's number 31, The Predator, versus number 35, Get Off My Dick and Tell Your Bitch to Come Here.
The Predator.
See, I gotta go with Get Off My Dick and Tell Your Bitch to Come Here because I love that song.
It's a great name though. That is a great name.
It's a great name, and I love that. I love that song. Like, yeah. It's just a good song. Like, yeah. I so want to say it to more people now. Like, it's just a thing. But Which way you want to go, Casey?
Yep.
Oh, I have a feeling she'd go with that. But CL, are you going to tie it up for Chancy and vote for the Predator, or are you going for a get off my dick and tell your bitch to come here?
Get off your dick and tell the bitch to come here. Just because that was just so disrespectful.
It is. It's so disrespectful.
All right. And last but not least, yeah. Chancy, which way would you have gone?
Get off my dick!
Jesus.
I'm pretty sure Casey says that to Vito all the time anyway, so you probably heard it before. But that means it's our last matchup on this half of round one, and it's going to be by our choice, number 34, Pop Gun One Nation featuring George Clinton, versus number 35, Get Off My Dick and Tell Your Bitch to Come Here. And this one's going to get started off by me, actually. Yeah. And I got to go with Pop Gun. It's just, to me, it's a more iconic Ice Cube song, and it's George Clinton. You can't hate George Clinton for nothing. I mean, he might have slept with your grandmama, for all you know, but, like, he was the man. He was the man. He still is the man. But which way you want to go there, Casey?
Pop Gun? Is that what it was called?
Yes, Pop Gun.
Yeah, that one.
And how about you? How about you, CL? Is Pop Gun moving on to the round two, or are you going to give it to
Pop Gun? Yeah, Pop Gun.
We get the finish. We get the finish talking about Pop Gun here. But, Chancy, which way you want to go?
I'm totally going with Pop Gun. That's my favorite Tom Cruise movie.
It cat's gonna tickle me.
Oh, I'm so glad that CJ laughed as hard as he did at that one. That was worth it. That was worth it. Poor CL's struggling.
And last but not least, CJ, which way you want to go?
Pop Gun.
The G or not the G is the question. And like Smith told Wesson, I'm shady with a 380 old school diploma. I leave that ass in a coma. So if you got a herringbone, welcome to the Terror Dome 211. Sorry, reference. Oh my God, getting robbed. Reach for the small atomic dog. Hard to swallow, janky ass wallow. Count to-
Let's move on to round two here. And round two is going to get started off by...
I think it's CL, isn't it?
It's Casey, I believe.
Oh.
Yeah, it's Casey. Is there a 2-minute intermission or anything?
I start off. No, you're right. You're right.
I just chose to go to church.
Yeah, so did I, but I thought I went first. But actually, I did go first. I know I did because I said, I'm actually.
Okay, my bad.
So it is Casey in this one. And it's.
Arguing ass motherfucker.
Shut up.
And it's number 14, Casey. Gangsta Rap Made Me Do It versus number 13, Friday.
Oh, yeah. Throw Your Neighborhood in the Air. I'm sorry. I just love that song.
Maybe don't care.
I'll go with Friday.
And CL?
I'm going to go with Friday.
And Chancy?
What day is it today?
Friday!
I'm going to murder everybody and Gangsta Rap Made Me Do It, just saying. But but which way you want to go, CJ?
I would go to church.
Oh, it's Gangsta Rap Made Me. It's Gangsta Rap Made Me Do It versus Friday.
Oh, Gangsta Rap Made Me Do It? Oh, fucking Friday then.
And it's not going to be a sweep in round two already because I would have gone with Gangsta Rap Made Me Do It. The beat in that song is fucking too outrageous. It shouldn't even be on a song. It's so good. And
it was a great beat, though.
And fucking Psychopathic Riders use that one too for another song. So, like, they use a lot of Ice Cube songs because he has amazing beats. But this one is going to see what Friday's going to be based.
Features by Jack Black. That's what the song.
Yeah. But to figure out what Friday's going to be facing in round two here, we're going to start this one off with CL, and it's number 27, Wicked. Versus number 11, the Ninja Trap.
Wicked.
And how about you, Chancelot?
Oh, absolutely. I'm sticking with Wicked.
And CJ?
Wicked.
And I'm happy about this one because I definitely voted for Wicked 2 on this one because Wicked's an amazing song. And it will face Friday in the quarterfinals. But which way would you have gone, Casey?
Wicked.
Which means we do our first sweep in round two, officially.
Sweep.
When he does that, is that loud on your end too, or just right in my eardrum?
I think it's just it's right in your eardrum, like a lot of things Chancy does with ears and eyes and sockets and all that. But
not mine, so don't know what you're talking about.
He's making an old joke about a skull fucking reference.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
How could you forget that? But that means the next matchup is gonna get started by Chancy.
I try.
And you try, but you you're dating him, so yeah, you know. But Chancy, number 25, A Gangsta's Fairy Tale versus number 24, Steady Mobbin.
I'm gonna go with Steady Mobbin.
And CJ?
What was it to again?
Gangsta's
Fairy Tale versus Fairy Steady Tale, Mobbin. Yeah.
Versus Steady Mobbin?
Versus Steady Mobbin, yeah.
Steady Mobbin.
And that means Steady Mobbin's moving on. I'm going for Steady Mobbin, too. That's a way better song than Gangsta's Fairy Tale. But which way would you have gone there, Casey?
Yep.
And CL, would it have been Steady Mobbin or Gangsta's Fairy Tale?
Gangsta's Fairy Tale.
Ooh, which means Steady Mobbin does not get a sweep, but still moves on. And it's going to be facing one of these two songs. And this might be a little hard, but CJ gets to start this one out. It's number 8, The Ninja You Love to Hate, versus number 34, Pop Gun One Nation featuring George Clinton.
Ooh, ouch. Pop Gun.
I'm gonna give
that's
one.
A hard one.
It is, but that's why I think I'm gonna give mine to The Ninja You Love to Hate, because I love that song. Like I like Pop Gun too, but The Ninja You Love to Hate is just more Ice Cube to me than Pop Gun. Like, I don't know, it seems like he was trying to be pop with that song or something. But what way you want to go, Casey?
Yeah, almost like it was called Pop Gun.
Yeah, but he was talking about he meant like real guns that, you know, but he was just using like the toy term.
Oh, I thought he was doing the Kenny Loggins thing and going into the danger zone.
He does that with most of his songs, so yeah, no worries there. But
that was so funny. I love how the like longer it went, just the more he started laughing, and now he is still laughing, continuing to lose his shit. Yes.
Oh my god. That was horrible.
Yeah, but you're still laughing. God damn it, Vito.
What? Get the fuck up out of here.
COVID.
Wait a minute, Casey. Vito was talking to you.
Must have been some other bitch.
Wait, what?
I think he was probably making a callback reference to the whole when you were saying not me when he was talking about the skull fucking thing.
Oh, it probably was.
I can't say that I've ever actually been around a girl that only had one eye.
We won't talk about Chancy's cotton candy encounter with old Betty, but that means that the next matchup, I believe we finished that one. Oh, no, we didn't finish that off completely, I don't think. Oh, no, we didn't. Which way did you go there, Casey?
I'm sorry, what were the options?
The Ninja You Love to Hate versus Pop Gun One Nation. Mm-hmm.
The love to hate one.
Oh, like our relationship. But which way? But which way you want to go, CL? The Ninja You Love to Hate or Pop Gun One Nation featuring George Clinton?
Pop Gun One Nation featuring George Clinton.
Oh, buddy.
Yep.
Which means Chancy gets a tiebreaker on this one.
That's tough. I love me some George Clinton, but... I'm going to go with the other one.
The Ninja You Love to Hate.
The one you love to hate.
And that means the Ninja is moving on to face Steady Mobbin in round...
In the quarterfinals. Yes. Set it up for an easy failure. That way Steady Mobbin can keep it on going.
But that's going to bring us to the other side of round two here. And, I mean, yeah, round two. And it's the first ones that get started off by myself. And it's number 22, Hello, featuring Dr. Dre and MC Ren.
Hello.
Versus number six, The Bomb. And I got to give it to Hello. But how about you, Casey?
One moment. She's previously.
Hello.
Well, is she off screen below you again, Chancy?
Ow. No, I pulled my hair.
Oh. CL, is it going to be Hello or The Bomb? Which means Hello. We'll move on to the core files, thank God.
Gangsta. Hello.
Which way would you have gone, Chancy?
Yes. I would have also gone with Hello.
And CJ?
Same here. Jeremy, sounds like your prisoners got loose.
My pigeons?
Your prisoners.
No, yeah. They're not loose, but they want to get out of their cage. I'm thinking they might have to go bathroom, so I'm going to let them out real fast if they go in my floor. But I'd rather they go on the cross on the base of the
floor. So how you been, CJ?
Hanging in there. Lots of work.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're way too much.
I mean, hopefully it pays well enough that it's worthwhile.
No, it doesn't. Not at all.
But
my clock's about 70 hours. Yeah.
That means we can start the next matchup to see what Hello's going to face in the quarterfinals. And this one gets started off by Casey. We're back at the top again. It's number 5, America's Most Wanted. Versus number 47, You Know How We Do. I mean, number 4. My bad.
You Know How We Do.
Oh, I do know how you do, girl. But, which way you want to go?
I started this gangster shit, and it's the motherfucking thanks I get.
Different matchup. It's America's Most Wanted versus You Know How We Do.
Oh, I just wanted to sing Hello again.
Oh, you'll get plenty more chances.
The first one, whatever the first one was, because I keep forgetting.
America's Most Wanted gets a vote. Which way do you want to go, Chancy?
This is how we do.
You know how we do. And CJ, how about you?
America's Most Wanted.
Which means it's a tiebreaker to me. And I got to go with You Know How We Do. I like that song a lot better. So, number 4, You Know How We Do, moves on. But
just saying, the black people voted for America's Most Wanted. Just saying.
But
you know, I think I made a mistake.
But You Know How We Do moves on to face Hello in the quarterfinals. And that means
that was strategic voting right there, see? So Hello's going to beat the shit out of that one.
Hopefully.
Oh, yeah, but, real. For real, will.
But that means the next matchup in the quarter in this round two here, the last two matchups actually, will be number 3, Check Yourself versus number 2, No Vaseline.
Oh.
And it gets started off by CL, I believe.
You said check yourself before you wreck yourself. I'm gonna go with No Vaseline because that can go hard.
Well, I mean. That's true. No Vaseline, you got to go hard. But
you should go soft with no Vaseline.
Yeah, bro.
You trying to cut your dick? What the fuck?
Why don't you try it with no Vaseline, my guy? Fast.
Rug burn is a real thing. Rug burn
is not cool. No. Mm.
Matt burn on your dick is no fun. Are you on the
receiving end of this?
I mean, I'm saying, with no Vaseline, you got to go harder. You're not going to get it in. I mean,
that's not good for either one of you.
Nah.
Jeremy.
Nah.
Take some lessons. The fuck.
Nah. Once you've had like a fucking second degree friction burn on your dick, fucking you really rethink your life's fucking decisions, man. I'm telling you.
Been there, done that. And I'm man on. But which way do you want to go, Chancy?
What were the options?
No Vaseline.
Oh yeah, definitely no Vaseline. I don't even hear. I don't even hear the other one. No Vaseline.
Which means check yourself. Still has zero votes. But which way you want to go, CJ?
I'm going in dry.
Took me a second there. But that means no Vaseline moves on. And I'll give one to check yourself just in case nobody else does. Because it definitely needs recognition. Recognition.
Yeah, Jeremy, check yourself.
But I like to wreck myself. But which way would you have gone, Casey, speaking of wrecking myself?
No Vaseline.
So that means no Vaseline will move on to the quarterfinals. Let's see what's going to face. Let's see what's going to face, though. This one gets started off by Fancy. And it's number 16, You Can Do It, versus number 15, Gangsta's Fairy Tale 2. Actually, I'm sorry, by Go Church, not Gangsta's Fairy Tale 2.
Go Church.
Copied the wrong one, apparently. And CJ?
All right, what are the two again?
You can do it.
Put your back into it versus Go Church.
Ooh, Go to Church.
Yeah, I have to give it to You Can Do It. I have to. But which way you want to go, Casey? You can do it, put your back into it, or Go to Church?
Somebody's pissed.
I'm not gonna be mad if she votes the other one. That's not how this works. She tries
if
to get me.
If my family is watching, go to church. But I mean, it's not. It's an Ice Cube song, so I don't know.
But
scared, go to church.
Yeah, if you're a scared motherfucker, go to church.
Casey, you could tie it up for CL the Herd side.
Huh?
You said you could tie it up and let CL decide. Or you can just vote, go to church, and it'll move.
I'll let CL decide.
What was the question? What's the choice?
Go to church, and you can do it, put your back into it.
I'm going to go, yeah. You can do it, put your
dick. Oh, why would you do that? Oh, no.
I knew she would do that, but.
I voted last time, so.
Yeah, that was a setup.
Oh, it was a setup in a way, but I also have no control over
her. Yeah, no. Yeah.
So I can't make anything happen on purpose. But that's gonna bring us to the quarterfinals now, after that very happy ending to round two.
Smoke some hay. You bitches wanna throw me up in Pelican's Bay. Call me an animal up in the system. But who's the animal that built this prison? Who's the animal invented lower living? The projects, thank God for Russell Simmons. Thank God for Sugar Hill. I'm putting a different kind of steel up to my grill. Y'all know what it is, scared for your own kids. How these ghetto niggas taking over showbiz. They give us guns and drugs. Can't wonder why in the fuck we thugs. They wanna count the slugs.
But the second half of round one is gonna start off by Casey, because we're back at the top, like I said. And it's number 7, Natural Born Killer, versus number 22, Hello, featuring Dr. Dre and MC Ren, basically an NWA reunion.
Hello, I started this gangsta shit, and this is the motherfucking thanks I get. Hello, just in case you didn't know.
Okay, what was the first one?
Natural Born Killer.
Yeah, I'll go with that one.
That's the people that want me to sing it. I'm still going with Hello.
I know. I'm sing all day.
Yeah.
CL, it's your vote, but so you want to go with Hello?
Hello.
Hey, yes. How are ya?
Hey, how are ya?
Oh, Chancy, which way you want to go before we get racist here?
What? I'm part native, dude. Fucking, I can do that shit. That's my thing.
Okay.
Do you know how long it took me to grow this beard?
I was going
to
say, that's true. Like,
it took me so long to get this beard to look like this.
You don't look it, but he is.
I'm going to go with, I love both of these songs, though. I love Natural Born Killers. It's such a good fucking song. But Hello is awesome.
Hello.
Just pick Hello. And then
fine. I'll pick Hello.
Yeah, there was no bullying there at all.
And
no peer pressure.
CJ, which way are you going?
This was a hard one. I love Hello, but I got to go with Natural Born Killers.
Which means it's a tiebreaker down to me. And this is one of my favorite Ice Cube songs ever, and it's definitely Hello.
Hello.
The fact that it's basically an NWA reunion, minus obviously the one person who can't be there for obvious reasons. But that's okay. I don't miss him that much anyway. But the three that are there are fucking incredible together. And
don't say that.
Feel free to listen to past episodes to hear me hate more than easy.
Blasphemous fucking son of a bitch.
He ain't no Ice Cube or Dr. Dre. He may be better than Ren a little bit, but that means that Hello will move on. But to see what Hello's going to face, this one gets started off by CL. And it's number 6, The Bomb, versus number 21, Why We Thugs.
The Bomb.
And how about you, Chancy?
Yup.
CJ?
The Bomb.
Y'all suck. I'm going with Why We Thugs because the beat in that song is the fucking bomb, like is the bomb. The beat in that song is the bomb. Like it's just amazing. And ICP did a song based on the Psychopathic Riots did a song based on that beat. So I gotta go with Why We Thugs because I fucking love that song. But which way would you have gone there, Casey?
Yep.
Yep to the bomb or Why We Thugs?
The bomb? Is that the bomb?
Yeah.
All
right, which means the bomb moves on to the second round.
41. I don't
want to
say the names wrong. Like,
unfortunately, because I think Why We Thugs is a way better song in my personal opinion. But I wish I could figure out how to block my gosh. But I can't block them straight. I don't know why. But that's what brings us to the next matchup here. And it's going to get started off by... I'm sorry, Chancy. Yeah, Chancy starts this one off. And it's number 5, America's Most Wanted with 3 Ks versus number 20, When I Get to Heaven.
America's Most Wanted, for sure.
DJ?
America's Most Wanted.
America's Most Wanted.
Ain't your turn yet, CL, but okay.
Hey, just mark it down. She's in the game, goddammit. That's all that matters. Well, she's on the right round with the right choices. Well, we'll just take it as a win.
Not yet. Because that could change shit. That could change shit, so we're not counting it yet. But I'm going with when I Get to Heaven because I like that song a lot better. But kind of reminds me of some other songs I've heard in the past, but
how can it change shit if it's still going to be her answer when it's her turn?
Because there's two people before her,
so it would still be her answer.
Only if it gets tied up. Oh, actually, okay, yeah, I guess.
I'm sorry.
Don't apologize. You apologize for nothing. You have done nothing wrong.
Yeah,
but Casey,
yeah,
which way
change your answer?
Casey, which way you want to go?
Let me change my answer.
No,
I forgot the options already.
It's America's Most Wanted versus When I Get to Heaven.
Oh, America's for Most Wanted.
America's Most Wanted.
Which means America's Most Wanted does move on regardless. But
listen, y'all, I've been awake since 4:30. All right.
CL, you still want to go with America's Most Wanted?
Sure.
Right. So America's Most Wanted moves on 4-1. I couldn't let it get a sweep. I couldn't.
Why, yes.
But to see what it's going to face, the next matchup gets started by CJ. And it's number four, You Know How We Do, versus number 19, Hood Robin.
Ooh. You Know How We Do.
All right. I'm going to give one to Hood Robin because I think Hood Robin is an amazing song. I love the lyrics in that fucking song so well. But which way you want to go, Casey?
Oh, fuck. See what happens when you fuck around and don't pay attention?
No.
She sold her vote. Just like, fuck it. Yes.
No.
I don't know.
It's Hood Robin versus You Know How We Do.
You Know How We Do.
There you go. Good job.
Thank you. I'll leave him alone now and pay attention. I'm sorry.
All right. Well, that means that it's going to be 2-3 at this point for You Know How We Do. And that brings it down to CL. Is it Hood Robin or You Know How We Do?
What was the choice?
You Know How We Do or Hood Robin?
Hood Robin.
All right, and that actually ties it up for Chancy. Is it Hood Robin or You Know How We Do?
You Know How We Do.
You Know How We Do. That's what I was going to go with, too.
No, you don't know how we do, Chancy, because you picked the wrong fucking answer.
Not according to everybody else in all these other windows, dude. Everybody's loving the shit out of it.
Yeah.
Well, someone else picked Hood Robin, but that means that I can start off this next one. Actually, this is a fucking hard one. God damn it. But it's number three. Well, actually, it's not a hard one. It's number three, Check Yourself, versus number 18, Giving Up the Nappy Dugout. I gotta go with Check Yourself, because you gotta check yourself before you riggedy wreck yourself.
Check yourself before you wreck yourself.
Yeah.
But which way you want to go, Casey?
Check Yourself.
I did grow on clean still. Come on. But CL, which way you want to go?
Check yourself before you wreck yourself.
You gotta do the riggedy wreck yourself thing first.
Oh, riggedy wreck yourself.
She tried. She tried, all right.
Whoa, Kat.
I don't
want to
sing like I did the last one, so I was trying to keep it
out. No, Maniacal Music supports karaoke in every form. But which way do you want to go, Chancy?
Oh, definitely fucking check yourself for sure.
Yeah.
And CJ, are we gonna have a sweep?
Oh yes, yeah, sweep. Song's amazing.
Which means it's our first sweep in this side of round one. And that brings us to the next matchup, which this is another hard one. And I'm not starting this one off, so I'm happy. It's gonna get started off by Casey. It's number two, No Vaseline. Versus number 17, The Wrong Ninja to Fuck With.
This is not a hard one.
No Vaseline was top tier.
I was going to say, No Vaseline.
Right?
Which is how she likes to do Chancy there. But, you know. CL, which way you want to go?
No Vaseline, definitely.
Giggity. How about you, Chancy?
Yup.
Which means No Vaseline does definitely move on to face Check Yourself in round two. Now that's gonna be a hard one, but
and
there ain't no Vaseline for either. That's the fun part. But which way would you have gone, CJ?
You see it. No Vaseline gonna win.
Yeah, I will give one to The Wrong Ninja to Fuck With, because that is a good song. I can't see you get hate on 100%. So
Yeah. It's a great song, but
yeah, no. Not against No Vaseline, though.
It's No Vaseline. It's the first real ever rap diss song that was actually good. So, I mean, it inspired a lot of amazing songs like Slim Anus and Nothing But a Bitch Thing and Please Don't Hate Me. If anybody didn't notice, I'm listening to three ICP songs that I hate on Eminem. But but that means that Casey, I mean, actually, I'm sorry, no. CL gets to start this one.
I was going to say, I just started.
Yeah, I'm working on it. It's been a long day. I smoked a lot of weed today. But
that's no excuse. Do better.
Not with weed in my system. But CL, which way are you going on this one? It's number one. The number one ranked song on this fucking bracket, which of course is It Was a Good Day, versus number 16, You Can Do It, aka Put Your Back Into It.
Oh, that makes it so hard.
I know. What the fuck?
Put your back into it. I can do it, put my ass into it. Or what was the other one?
Today was a good day.
Ooh. Oh man, I'm gonna go with fuck you up when you're mad to say fuck you, Jeremy, right? Okay, that's tough. Today was a good day, but if I'm twerking, I'm gonna put my back into it. So today, just waking up in the morning, gotta thank God. That's it. I'm gonna go with today was a good day.
It was a good day, gets one vote.
And that can be that ass drop.
and she definitely put some back into that one. But Chancy, which way you want to go?
God damn it!
Yeah, this matchup's the hardest one. The whole fucking thing, I'm telling you.
I'm going. Today was a good day. I fucking love that song. It's really good. The other one's good too, but I mean, you know.
Well. I am hoping I can count on my person going next year to help me out. CJ, is it? It's a good day.
Put your back into it. Put your back into it. I can do it. Put your ass into it. What? No. Yep,
which you can do it was actually on my five sex songs on the sex song bracket. So
mine is still the best.
I am definitely going with you can do it, put your ass into it.
Put your back.
I can't believe that today is a good day is possibly gonna lose here, man.
I don't feel like it was better than today's a good day.
I mean, and my dogs are literally looking at me when I say this stuff, like what the fuck's wrong with you? But that brings the tiebreaker to Casey.
Don't fuck it up, Casey.
Ow, this fucking cat. The cat
Casey.
Fun.
She got attacked by some pussy and fucking all of a sudden all hell
ass.
She's fucking choosing put your back
ass.
Yes.
Yes, thank you, Casey.
This is a fucking tragedy.
Oh, well, yes. You should
the horror show has been done.
You should know your wifey there wants a mask there, Casey. I mean, Chancy, come on.
But the one that says, or you know, she says put your back into it. He says put your ass into it. So in turn, I would be the one telling her to put her ass into it, which I have to go on record and saying she need not be reminded.
Oh, Jesus Christ, Chancy. Jesus Christ.
What? Open up a door. I'm on the other side. What's up, motherfucker? Surprise, motherfucker.
Small fries, motherfucker.
Right. Supplies, well, motherfucker.
Rude dies, motherfucker.
Well, listen, I'm Mace Windu here, motherfuckers. Let's go. But to figure out the last match in round one, we need to do two more play-ins first. Because this is a 36 song bracket, if I didn't say that. But it's the first matchup is going to get started off by Chancy. And it's number 32, Go to Church, featuring Snoop Dogg, versus a song that wasn't on the list, but I threw in because it had to get thrown in. And that is Good Cop, Bad Cop, which is basically a sequel to Fuck the Police.
Y'all can't fuck with the police. Y'all can't fuck with the police.
But Chancy, which way you want to go?
I can really go with the first one.
Go to church, motherfucker.
But, go to church, motherfucker.
But CJ, which way you want to go?
Go to church.
Okay, I have to go with Good Cop, Bad Cop because it literally is a sequel to Fuck the Police. He uses some of the same lines in it too, like black police trying to show up for the white cops. Like,
yeah. Fucking. Oh, so he repeated himself. Okay, yeah, no, I can't vote for that one.
He can repeat himself for that. It's a fucking sequel to one of the greatest rap songs ever made. But
doesn't make it better than Go to Church.
But Go to Church is good. I can't deny it. But Casey, which way you want to go? Good Cop, Bad Cop, or Go to Church?
Go to Church.
Fuck y'all. Jeremy, I'm taking my ball and going home. Damn y'all.
You're already home, Jeremy.
That's not his home.
Screw you guys. I'm leaving my serial killer basement and going upstairs.
But which way do you want to go? Which way would you have gone, CL?
Which choices again?
Go to church or Good Cop, Bad Cop.
Go to church. This is definitely an afternoon show. This is not a nighttime show.
I'm sorry, I don't get off of work until late. I can't help it. This is
definitely like a 6 to 7.
Aren't they like an hour?
She's an hour ahead of us.
Oh yeah, that sucks.
I'm motherfucking hour ahead of you too.
I know. You're used to it, sir.
So I fucked that up myself.
I am used to it, but let's do our other play-in match here to figure out what Go to Church will be facing in the first round, and. This one gets started off by CJ, and it's number 33, Us, versus number 15, Gangsta's Fairy Tale 2.
Oh, Gangsta's Fairy Tale.
It's the second Gangsta's Fairy Tale, though, not the first one.
Oh, I know. He had to come back and finish it off. Good.
Gangsta Paradise.
On this one, I got to go with Us. I think it has a more powerful message, and the second Gangsta's Fairy Tale is not as good as the first one. I got to say that. But Casey, which way you want to go?
I'm sorry, what were the options?
Jesus Christ. Us versus
Don't Gangsta. Do that. He literally was messing with his phone.
I got a notification letting me know that my Amazon shipments of most of the entire discography of Dog Fashion Disco was headed my fucking way. What are the options?
It's Us versus Gangsta's Fairy Tale 2.
Gangster's Fairy Tale. Two.
And
is it one?
Yes.
Yeah, we already hit that.
Oh,
but see, we hit that fairy tale already. Come on now. But CL, are you gonna tie it up for Chancy by going with Us, or are you gonna go for Gangster Fairy Tale 2?
Us.
Which is Sir Chancelog, it's a tiebreaker here.
I'm gonna go Gangster's Fairy Tale 2.
I can't be mad. But I don't think it's going to have much chance going on anyway yet, because we are at the last matchup of round one. And it's the last two songs we voted in. It's number 32, Go to Church, versus number 15, Gangsta's Fairy Tale 2. I start us off, and on this one, I will say Go to Church, because it's better than Gangsta's Fairy Tale 2 by far. But Casey, how about you?
Go to Church.
And CL, is Go to Church going on?
Going to church.
And Chancy?
Yeah.
And CJ, do we have our final sweep of round one?
Oh, definitely.
Which means that Gangsta's Fairy Tale 2 gets to move in to round two to face You Can Do It. And that will bring us to the end of round one.
Break them off some. Yeah. Good cop, rolling with that bad cop. What you doing, boy? Turning that blood clock, buckshot. They fly
through the truck spots, robots. Can't give a damn who the fuck shot. Clean cop, fucking with that dirty cop. Don't act like your ass never heard of that. Clean cop, rolling with that mean cop. Still trying to act proud as a peacock. You know that mean cop might need a detox. Motherfucker tried to blow me out my Reeboks, but I swing like Jack in the.
And the first matchup in the quarterfinals is going to get started off by CJ. And it's number 13, Friday, versus number 27, Wicked.
Oh, damn. Oh, you're an ass. Shit.
Y'all made this matchup, not me. Not me alone.
I love Friday so much, but I got to go with Wicked.
And I'm going to agree with you 100%. I have to go with Wicked, too. I have to.
I'm going
to
go with Friday because that's some bullshit.
Well, Casey, first thing first, Casey, which way are you going to go?
Friday versus Wicked.
Friday.
Oh, yeah. Throw your neighborhood in the air. Oh, bum,
bum. Which since CL prematurely voted, that means, Chancy, you get a tiebreaker here between Wicked and Friday.
I got to go with Friday. Oh, I got to do it.
You suck.
I'm sorry, CJ.
Hey, actually, I can't be mad at this one. That's a tough one.
Literally Friday and fucking It Was a Good Day are like the two songs from Ice Cube that I heard first. And I was just like, oh, man, this is so fucking awesome. And then I heard America's Most Wanted and Natural Born Killers. And I was like, oh, my God.
Yeah, right.
Well, this next matchup to see what Friday's going to face is going to get started by me. And it's number 24, Steady Mobbin, versus number eight, The Ninja You Love to Hate. And I give it to Steady Mobbin because it's Steady Mobbin. But which way you want to go, Casey?
Yeah, I'll go Steady Mobbin too.
And how about you, CL?
What was the two choices?
Steady Mobbin and The One You Love to Hate.
I want to go whatever Casey said because I don't like those two.
Steady Mobbin.
Steady. Which means Steady Mobbin moves on to face Friday in the semifinals. But which way would you have gone, Chancy?
I also would have chose Steady Mobbin.
And CJ?
I would have chosen Ninja You Love to Hate.
Because fuck you, Ice Cube. But that brings us to the other side of the quarterfinals here. And it's going to start off with Casey. And it's number 22, Hello, versus number 4, You Know How We Do.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
And CL, does that mean you're going to go the same thing?
What was Hello going up against?
You Know How We Do.
Hello.
And Chancy?
Oh, hello.
Hey, how are ya? Hey, how are ya? Hey, how are ya? Oh, wait. Yeah. Yeah, I'm going with hello.
And CJ?
Hello.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Because you know I started this gangsta shit.
And this is the motherfucking gangsta I get? Hello.
But that means hello is moving on to the semifinals. And I'm definitely going to give that a fucking sweep. Because it's hello. That's my favorite Ice Cube song by far. But, this final matchup for the quarterfinals here is going to be a hard one. And CL gets to take this hard one. And she gets to take it.
Oh, that's what he said.
And she gets to take it with no Vaseline versus versus You Can Do It.
Damn, I gotta fuck it either with no Vaseline or I can do it and put my back into it.
No,
I mean, in theory, you could do both.
I mean, there's a.
So, I'm a baby boat. No Vaseline. I'm spontaneous. Ow.
I mean, there's also a comma there. It's you can do it with no Vaseline, comma, you can do it.
No Vaseline is my vote.
How about you, Chancy? No Vaseline or you can do it? Put your back into it.
No Vaseline.
And CJ?
No Vaseline.
Oh, goddamn, y'all. Right, I'm giving it one that you can do it because that's an amazing song and there's a reason it was one of my sex songs. But there's a reason.
I think you could do it as a sex song. I think it's a club song. So if you fucking and you could do it, you just got other shit on you. I don't know what's wrong with you.
It was in my sex songs list for the sex songs bracket back in February.
I'm telling you, I still think mine was the best. My song, one of my songs on my list was the best song of all time.
Yeah, we know, Chancy. Alphabet Aerobics. Yeah,
dude, for real. Dude, Gift of Gab was a fucking genius, all right?
Gift of Gab.
He was the guy that, he was in Blackalicious. He was the guy on the mic doing the raps. Unfortunately, he died, which sucks because he was actually getting popular again after fucking Harry Potter did the alphabet aerobics on one of the fucking late night shows.
But that brings us down to the last person here, Casey. Which way would you have gone? No Vaseline, or you can do it.
No Vaseline.
Which means no Vaseline wins 4-1, unfortunately. And that right there, folks, concludes the quarterfinals. And that's going to bring us to the semifinals.
But if you think we hot, you can think again. Because when it's sink or swim, you got to think to win. And if I drink this in, everybody will know it. Because I ain't going for it. So pray to the Lord that I don't pull out. Cuss out and bust out. Go to the crowd. Make the trigger shout. You can try to smoke an ounce to this. Well, I pronounce this. Baby, bounce them. I'ma move them hips. Baby, shake them cheeks. I got but they, you got for weeks.
Don't stop, get it, get it.
That's real.
Don't stop, get it.
I will. I'm going to do it.
And these are not going to be easy by any fucking means. I'm telling you that right now. And it's going to start off on this side with CL. And it's number 13, Friday, versus number 24, Steady Mobbin.
Friday.
And how about you, Chancy?
Oh, yes. Most definitely Friday, sir.
CJ, please don't disappoint me. Is it Steady Mobbin or Friday?
Friday.
He does. Yes, he said Friday.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm giving my vote to Steady Mobbin because I have to. Like it ain't going out with a sweep, and it's a fucking amazing song. So the Lynch Mob will always be Steady Mobbin. But fucking Christ, you damn dogs.
I got about 10 minutes before this dies. Just want to say that.
Yeah, this will be over in about 10 minutes or less.
Okay, cool.
If I get this fucking ball today. There we go. All right. Well, which way would you have gone, Casey?
I'm sorry.
Steady Mobbin or Friday?
Friday.
Which means Friday. Friday moves on to the finals, 4-1. And that brings us to the other side of the semifinals here. And this one gets started off by Chancy. Is it number 22, Hello, or number 2, No Vaseline?
No Vaseline. I love Hello and everything, but come on, it's No Vaseline. This should be Friday versus No Vaseline, and everybody knows that I'm right.
But CJ, how about you? Do you agree with Chance a lot?
Yes, I do. No Vaseline.
All right, well. I'm giving a vote to Hello because I fucking love Hello. And I think it's Ice Cube's best song. It's Ice Cube's best song, in my opinion. But which way you want to go there, Casey? Hello or no Vaseline?
No Vaseline.
Which means no Vaseline does move on to the finals. But which way would you have gone? Yeah.
No Vaseline.
Which means no Vaseline moves on 4-1 against Hello. But that brings us to the finals officially.
With the fat man skills, and I won't choke like the Buffalo Bills. Sitting at the pad just chilling, cause Larry Parker just got me 2 million. Oh, what a feeling. So shake that nigga and pass me the pill. And I'll slam dunk it like Shaquille O'Neal. Like it, dig it, maybe. And watch that test tube, baby. Kick it, cause I
you
get
know that wicked. Ice Cube, I touch a game of song. Yes, yeah. I'm wicked. If you cut the mic and cross off the cone. Yes, I'm wicked. All of them gotta win this song. Yeah. My name is Don Jaguar, and Ice Cube, we run the town.
Wicked. Look at the way y'all make it. I'm wicked.
And I'm a little surprised at the finals, to be completely honest here. Actually, really surprised. I did not see it going this way in the slightest. But you know, with no Vaseline, you go in all types of angles and directions so you get to the right way. But that means that CJ is going to start off the finals here. And it's number 13, Friday, versus number 2, No Vaseline.
You know how it is. No Vaseline all day.
And I'm going to agree with you.
I don't no Vaseline
because
all day. Hold up. No Vaseline all day. This motherfucker want rug burn on that dick. I'm scared of that.
I ain't getting up.
That's going to be some cheap trolls right there. But
he going to start a fucking fire with that dick.
Well,
only
I hear that.
You all, can prevent forest fires.
That's some scary shit. Oh, you start fires, the fuck wrong with you?
Well, call me Smokey the Bear because I hear that shit all the time. But
that's how you shave.
Oof, nothing like starting a good fire. But which way do you want to go, Casey? No Vaseline or Friday?
No Vaseline.
Chancy, you
he's disgusted with this moment.
No, I'm not. I'm actually very happy with this outcome because I out of these two, I gotta go with that one as well, as I did. But Seattle, which way would you have gone, even though no Vaseline's moving on and winning this bracket?
That's it. What did I say?
No Vaseline, number one.
No Vaseline, because I don't even know what
it
was going up against.
And last but not least, Chancy, which way would you have gone? Would no Vaseline have got a sweep in the finals?
Yeah, damn right.
Which means no Vaseline is the first one.
You better check yourself or you wreck yourself, cause I'm bad for your health. I come real stealth, dropping bombs on your moms, kill car alarms. Doing foul crime, I'm that brother with the Alpine 3460. Always let tricks know and friends know we got that endo. No, I'm not a sucker, sitting in a house of pain. And no, I'm not the butler, I'll touch ya, headbutt ya. You say you can't touch this, and I wouldn't touch ya. Punk, you a sucker, here to let you know, boy. Oh boy, I make dough, but don't come and go.
And Friday would be the second. But we need to figure out who would be third and fourth in this, Bianch. And that means it's going to be number 22, Hello, versus number 24, Steady Mobbin.
Hello!
And I'm going first in this one. I'm agreed. Going first in this one. And Hello is getting my vote. But how about you, Casey?
Hello.
And CL, I assume you're voting for Hello. That means Hello's getting third place here, and Stay Mobbing be getting fourth. But which way would you have gone there, Chancy?
Yeah.
All right. And how about you, CJ? Would it have been a full sweep?
Damn.
All right. So this bracket ends up with Steady Mobbing being fourth, Hello being third, Friday being second, and number two on the rankings, No Vaseline winning first place. But yeah. I want to thank all participants for participating. And be sure to come back next week, same time, same place, for our Will Smith, a.k.a. My Birthday Bracket. We'll be breaking down all the songs of Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince first, and as also some songs from Will Smith's solo career. So, but CL, where can they find you?
Y'all can find me each and every motherfucking Thursday, 9 p.m. Eastern time on CL Presents Pussy Talks.
And when that pussy talks, you better listen, gentlemen. But
or make it speak in tongues. I don't know.
But CJ, put that tongue in good use. Where can they find you?
Right now, doing season to season with Casey and Dre. And yeah, don't forget to vote DeAndre Robinson for president in 2024. It's hashtag Dre 2024.
And Chancy, where can they find you?
Well, you know, naturally they can find me in the Book of Faces, Instagram and TikTok as the Red Eye Roundtable, Twitter as Red Eye Table. You know, The Void. I hang out there a lot. Lots of cool cats there.
And of course, you can find his better half, Casey, up underneath Chancy. Up underneath Chancy with no Vaseline. But
it was another night of set.
But you can find both Chancy and I at on Facebook as Paranormal Normal / Maniacal Music Musings podcast for the S group. Name changing soon. And you can find us on Twitter and the Gram as that Juggalo Bastard. You can find us on TikTok as that Juggalo Bastard podcast. And there'll be a lot of clips from this one on there, I guarantee it. And you could find us on YouTube as Maniacal Music Musings. And of course, you can now find us on the Blind Knowledge Network, where we are one of 15 glorious podcasts for you to check out. But until next week, actually, we'll be back this Tuesday, the regular episode for the first time in a few weeks.
Yeah,
but,
right. I was like, wait a minute.
But until next Friday, when we do the Will Smith bracket, you can come see us either of those days. Your Musers are out. Have a good night, everybody. And remember, MC Ren likes to do it with no Vaseline.
Damn. Forgot to do something. Let me see. Oh, yeah. It ain't over, motherfuckers.
The motherfucking saga continues.
Y'all motherfuckers ready for a W.A.? Well, get the fuck up!
Now, since he stepped the fuck off.
Here's what they think about you. 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 Here's what they think about.
Here's what they think.
Here's what they think about.
Here's what they. Here's what they think about.
Here's what they think about.
Here's what they think about.
Fuck all y'all.
Goddamn, I'm glad y'all set it off. Used to be hard, now you just wet and soft. First you was down with the AK, and now I see you on a video with Michelle, looking like straight bozos. I saw it coming, that's why I went solo. And kept on stomping while y'all motherfuckers moved straight out of Compton. Living with the whites, one big house and not another nigga in sight. I started off with too much cargo, dropped four niggas, now I'm making all the dough. White man just ruling. The niggas with attitudes, who you fooling? Y'all niggas just phony. I put that on my mama and my dead homies. Yellow boys on your team, so you're losing. Hey yo, Drake, stick to producing. Calling me owner, but you been a dick. Easy E saw your ass and went in it quick. You got jealous when I got my own company. But I'm a man, and ain't nobody helping me. Trying to sound like American Most. You can yell all day, but you don't come close. Cause you know I'm the one that flow. You done ran 100 miles, but you still got one to go. With the L-E-N-C-H-M-O-B, and y'all disgrace to CPT. Cause you're getting fucked out your green by a white boy with no Vaseline. MC Ren shit, tried to tell you a year ago, but Willie D told me to let a hoe be a hoe, so I couldn't stop you from getting ganked. Now let's play Big Bank, take Little Bank. Tried to diss Ice Cube, it wasn't worth it, cause the broomstick fits your ass so perfect. Cut my hair, now cut them balls, cause I heard you like giving up the draws. Gang bang by your manager, fella, getting money out your ass, like a motherfucking ready teller. Giving up the dollar bills, not a be my homie, now you act like you don't know me. It's a case of divide and conquer, cause you let a juke break up my crew. House nigga got a running high, yelling Compton, but you moved to Riverside. So don't front, MC Ren, cause I remember when you drove a B210, broke as a motherfucking joke. Let you on the scene to back up the first team. It ain't my fault, one nigga got smart and they ripping your asshole apart by cutting your grin. Oh yeah, the villain does get fucked with no Vaseline.
With the president, I never have dinner with the president. I never have dinner with the president.
And when I see your ass again, I'll be hesitant. Now I think you a snitch. Throw a house nigga in a ditch. Half pint bitch, fucking your homeboys, you little maggot. Easy E turn faggot with your manager, fella. Fucking MC Ren, Dr. Dre, and yeah. But if they were smart as me, Easy E'll be hanging from a tree with no Vaseline. Just a match and a little bit of gasoline. Light him up, burn him up, flame on. So that Jerry Curl is gone. On a permanent vacation, off the massive plantation. Heard you both got the same.